Nissan Bolavanaka and welcome to Tangata Pasifika.
Kia ora nakato kato to. Tonight on the show, Hawaii sensation Kaloi Kai.
In Christchurch, Pacific communities are rallying around the Pacific Hub.
We've had nearly 1,000 families that have been helped just in the last week.
And a special treat, Vince Harder with us in studio.
But first, to propose welfare changes. Pacific people on benefits are in line for a real shake-up as part of the government's review of the current welfare system.
The Welfare Working Group tabled its report in Parliament on the same day as the Christchurch earthquake, meaning it's been put on the back burner for now.
However, the government is committed to reducing the number of beneficiaries and saving money. Sandra Kailahi takes a look at some of the proposed changes.
Mary Naylor's been on the domestic purposes benefit since her son David was born 10 months ago. When he was 6 months old, she went back to work part-time.
I thought it's going to be easy for me to work and also take care of my son. But then I found out it's hard, it's very hard for me. And that's why now I'm going back to being on the DBB benefit.
Under current law, Mary doesn't have to look for part-time work until David turns six. That'll change to three if the government adopts the welfare group's recommendations.
Now we see in the wider population, by the age of three, 50% of women have re-entered the labour force. And what we're really saying is we should expect to see the same patterns amongst the benefit population as we do amongst the wider population.
And the government is looking at offering single parents like Mary training incentives to help them get off the benefit.
I think we could do better by those women and their children and supporting them, giving them the right sort of training and making sure the right childcare is there for them as well.
But as Mary already knows, that's not really ideal.
It took ages for me to be on the course and then waiting for a job. But I'm not quite sure if I can do that. Yeah, all I need is to just get a job.
Mary is one of the over 61,000 Pacific people currently on a benefit in New Zealand, and they will all be affected by the changes. The recommendations include all benefits will be replaced with a single payment called Job Seeker Support. Parents will have to look for part-time work once the youngest child turns three. Beneficiaries must start a work plan on how they intend to get back into work. Any parent that has a child while on welfare will need to look for work when the child reaches 14 weeks old. Free contraception will be available to all women on welfare. But not everyone's convinced these changes are good. Vi Harris has worked in budgeting since 1989. She says people are hurting and these changes won't help.
Only my concern now is a DPP lady with a little kids. I think the main thing, you're going to look after those kids and a lot of daycare too. You know, it's a costing, it affects them. Yes, they do want to work, but where's the work? There's no job around.
And with the Pacific unemployment rate the highest in the country at 14.4%, compared with the national average of 6.8%, finding good jobs is a real concern.
I know looking for a job now, it's hard, and it's still, it took ages for all the companies to call me. They now got available jobs for me. So that's why I'm now looking for a job.
There's no word on what the government will do, but John Key's reportedly not keen on making parents return to work when the baby is 14 weeks old. Whatever happens, it's likely some changes may take place before the election, with the rest next year.
To music now, they're young, they're Hawaiian, and they're the hottest reggae sensation for many of our Pacific youth.
They are the band Kaloi Kai, and they've just finished a whirlwind tour of New Zealand.
Marama Papau, who's a big fan herself, caught up with some of the band when they were in Porirua. Surfing right some more.
It's Hawaiian reggae group Kolohe Kai's first trip here, and they've had an overwhelming response from New Zealand fans.
We were expecting it, but like not like that.
You're my dream girl, living in my
their music has had some airplay on local radio, but it's online where you really see how popular Kolohe Kai is, one of their songs on YouTube reaching almost 1 million hits.
Pretty amazing to see comments from people all across the world, you know. Never expected that to happen. I think a lot of it has to do with the kind of music we play. It seems like a genre that would be open to any kind of age. It's not just a specific, you know, age group. So whether it's, you know, young kids or adults, I think a lot of people can enjoy the type of music we play.
The hills make me wanna run and play every time I think of you.
The band began while they were still at high school. The main singer and songwriter for the group is 19-year-old Roman DiPeralta. He was resting his vocal cords for the gigs during this interview.
Roman's not here right now, so now you guys can dish all the dirt you want. What's Roman really like?
He's a wonderful guy, you know, real to the heart. He takes everyone for who they are and just is more into their spirituality and just the human beings that they are.
Is he single?
Currently, yes.
I think he's single. I don't know.
He doesn't speak too much about it. But he is infatuated with girls. Their beauty.
And beautiful girls, yes, I've seen a few.
What's Ehu Girl about to you guys then?
Well, it's Ehu means, if you translate to Hawaiian, it's sun dyed. So it's like a different tinge or color of hair. So in Hawaii, you know, girls that surf, they stay in the sun, they have that reddish tint kind of to their hair. And it's pretty much what a Ehu girl is.
Kolohe Kai are about to release their second album called Love Town, and fans should expect a slightly different flavor.
The second album shows a lot of maturity. You know, in the first album, kind of has the young, innocent style. And then, I'm not saying we're grown up, but, you know, it shows like a sophomore level style of music and just tells us a little more advanced than the first album.
The band is looking at touring Aussie later in the year and are hoping to return to New Zealand. Great news for keen fans.
Will you be back to New Zealand?
We're hopeful.
Yes, so. Please, bring us back.
Yeah. Well, it'd be awesome to see them back. Mm. And we've got a Kolohe Kai New Zealand Tour T-shirt to give away. So if you want it, all you have to do to be in to win is record yourself or you and your mate singing the Kolohe Kai track and post it on our Tangata Pasifika Facebook page.
You know, you can even grab out the ukulele as well if you want to. And maybe we can get Kolohe Kai to judge it, yeah?
Yep.
You're my pretty little ehu girl. What do you reckon?
It's good. Good, Tom. Stay with us. Coming up next.
We never got power here until day 15.
Christchurch Pacific community rebuilding together.
And we catch up with Vince Harder.